Well, howdy there, Internet people. It's Bo again. So today we're going to talk about a teachable moment that's happening right now. Something that's coming out of the failed reopenings. That's what they are. If you don't know, a lot of President Trump's greatest allies, those who stood beside him when he said, you know, everything was fine, don't worry about it, we don't need to close down, we need to reopen, we need to get the economy back on track, that's our main focus, it's not really going to be that bad. Those who stood by him, those who reopened their states, those who started that process before scientists said it was advisable, well, who could have guessed it? They're having to stop the reopenings. They're having to scale things back. In Florida and in Texas, this is happening. We can focus on the political aspects of this and how a whole bunch of people are now going to show up to vote against Governor DeSantis because of this, and therefore they'll end up voting against Trump. Yeah, that's worth noting, but there's a much bigger teachable moment here. What happened? Scientists came out and they said, hey, this is going to happen. This is what the models say. This is what we have to do to fix it. These are our options. Those with the money in the U.S., those with the economic power, they didn't like the suggestions of the scientists. So they created this counter-narrative. And they had the politicians who they greatly influence support that counter-narrative. And then a bunch of people playing partisan politics, a bunch of people who wanted to play their part in the culture war, well, they signed on to it. And they agreed with it. And they started promoting this counter-narrative. And then, big surprise, the scientists were right. So now we have to roll back all the reopenings. Let's apply that to something else. You have an overwhelming consensus of scientists saying, hey, this is the projection. This is what's going to happen. It's really dangerous. We have to make changes. We need to reduce our carbon output. We have a whole bunch of stuff we need to do to save the entire planet. And what happened? A whole bunch of people with money, those who were threatened by this advice, they created a counter-narrative. And those politicians who they greatly influence, they promoted it. And people who wanted to play their part in the culture war, they promoted it. So it took hold, this anti-science narrative. The difference between the two scenarios when you're talking about us having to reclose now and climate change is that if it gets too far with climate change, there's no turning it off. We have to make the changes now. This was a great moment. It showed exactly what's happening with that debate, and it showed the outcome. The difference is if climate change gets way out of control and becomes an extinction level event, which it can. A governor's not going to be able to sign a piece of paper and roll things back. It's done. We've got to get rid of these politicians. These politicians who are supporting moneyed interests over your life. You've seen it now. You've seen it happen. This same thing is happening with climate change. We have to address it. We don't have a choice. You can continue to play your part in the culture war, but it's going to turn out the same way. We have one planet, and the governors and the presidents and the leaders of the world will not be able to do anything once it gets past a certain point. We have to stop listening to the people who would put profits over people's lives. Anyway, it's just a thought. Y'all have a good night.